Our ROVs are very easy to operate. The biggest variable is how challenging the environments you're working in and the application you're looking to perform. If you're working in clear water in a small area with a clear objective, such as a tank inspection, there's virtually no training required. A bit of practice in a pool and you're ready to operate. For environments where the water's murky and the current is strong, and you're trying to find a specific target, such as an underwater mine or drowning victim, it can be more challenging. Users typically opt for a sonar in this case, which takes more practice. We do offer virtual and in-person training for these cases. Even with the added challenge, most of our customers still find our systems easy to use, and that little bit of extra training helps them speed up the learning curve. This is a common question. However, the answer isn't as simple as just a number or a specification. The answer depends on the application. In general, ROV inspections and surveys can be broken down into two main categories: driving to a single point or performing a thorough area or object survey. When swimming to a single location, an ROV is able to take on more current because the flight path it takes to get there doesn't matter, as long as it gets to the target. Additionally, there are tools to help guide you, such as USBL positioning systems, imaging sonars, and heading and depth sensors. The DTG-3 can fight through up to 2 knot currents to a target, while the Pivot and Revolution can fight through 2.5 to 3 knot currents in most environments. Seaweed presents a challenge for any thruster vehicle, particularly on low-cost ROVs. We do offer thruster guards, but even these aren't foolproof. The advantage of Deep Trekker ROVs are our magnetically coupled drives and our unique in-house configurations. These thrusters will immediately recognize a jam and initiate a thruster fault. This kills power to the thruster and allows the operator to retrieve the ROV to clear any debris, removing any risk of damage. The ROV cameras will see about roughly as well as a human eye would underwater. If the water is extremely murky, sensors for heading and depth can tell you what direction you're moving through the water, while things like imaging sonars or USBL systems can be integrated for sight and positional awareness. Retrieving underwater objects is a common application for Deep Trekker ROVs. Our customers use our vehicles to lift objects in a few different ways. The first method is to grab onto the object and pull it up using the tether. In this instance, the tether brake strength is 150 kilos or 300 pounds, which is going to be your limitation for this method of retrievals. When grabbing onto an object and swimming with it using the ROV, the dimensions of the object will be your limiting factor. Some of the objects may be difficult to grasp or be shaped in a way that generates more drag. On average, the DTG-3 can lift about 2 pound objects, while the Pivot and Revolution can lift 4 to 8 pounds. The last common method for recovering objects is to hold a carabiner in the grabber claw and hook or tie the object to a line, then use this line to recover the object. This method is typically used for large equipment recoveries using our 5-ton retrieval kit. A tether is required for live video communications, sensor feedback, and control through pipelines or underwater environments. Radio waves really don't travel very well through ground or water, making a tethered connection the only solution for reliable operation. Our ROV tethers can be extended up to 700 meters or 2,300 feet, and are manufactured to be flexible and lightweight and maintain a 300 to 1,000 pound braking strength. If you're interested in going further than that, contact us for alternative solutions. ROVs provide live feedback and control, whereas an AUV deploys in a pre-programmed mission. In most cases, these two are complementary pieces of technology rather than substitutes for one another. AUVs are better suited for large sweeping surveys, while the ROV can be deployed to investigate the anomalies identified in the survey. ROVs are also better options for structural inspections, particularly in smaller enclosed spaces. Yes, both the primary and auxiliary lights are dimmable via the programmable arrow buttons on your Deep Trekker bridge controller.